Hi, this is Alex from phpacademy.org back with another video for the new Boston. Now in this video we're going to be looking at different string functions inside PHP, how you use them and why they might be useful. So we're going to go through a few string functions in this video, and we're just going to use an example string along the way. So let's go ahead and create our example string. So I'm going to create a new variable called string, and this is going to be equal to a particular string. So for example, I'm going to say this is an example string. So we're going to be doing a few things with this particular string along the length of the videos that we're going to create, and we're going to be creating new variables which use these functions and apply these functions to this particular string. So first of all, let's go ahead and look at string word count. Now you can imagine why this may be useful in particular situations. You might want to count a certain amount of words, maybe through user input or through database use, etc., etc. But I'm sure you can find a use in your own web application. But for now, this is how you use it. Now I'm going to create a new variable called string word count. And this is going to be equal to the function name, which is str word count. Now this function takes three arguments in total. Only one of them is required, and the one that is required is the actual string itself. So I'm just referencing this variable here, which is equal to this string here. So let's go down here and echo this out, and then we'll talk about the different arguments we can give this function to perhaps make it more useful to us. Okay, so let's go ahead to our browser and refresh the page and see what we have. Okay, so we get a value of 5 returned when we echo out the result of this function. So you can see that we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 words. The full stop doesn't count, that's not included in our list of words. We can specify things that we want to class as words, maybe symbols later on, but for now this is how many words are in the string. Now let's go ahead and look at an argument we can give this. So we can give this the second argument as 0, 1, or 2. So I'll go through each one and explain which one which is which. So 0 is what we've already seen. This just returns an integer value, as we've already seen, with the amount of words in there, with no other arguments specified. 1 will produce an array where the key is equal to the word itself. So, you know, the key is irrelevant in this. It will just be the default. So it'll be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then each value of each key will contain the word in the string. So what we're actually doing is we're creating an array and we're almost splitting this up. So let's go ahead and try and echo this out, and you'll see that we'll just get a value here of array. This is because it's now stored as an array after we've given this argument. So what we can do, just to be quick, is we can use this print r here and enclose the word count in this, and this will display all the elements of an array. Oh, spelled that wrong. Okay, so print r, let's go back, refresh, and now what you can see is we've got 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and these, all these keys that we've been returned equal the words that we have. So we're not using an associative array here, we're using just a normal array, and we've got this is an example string without the full stop like I mentioned earlier. So that's how we're going to put our results into an array. Now if we use a string with the argument 2, this is going to return an associative array. Now as you can see here, we've got each key is as normal, so we start at 0 and we're ending at 4. What this will now do is the key will equal the position, so the key will now become an associative value. It will have the position of where each word starts, and then the value of each key will be the word itself. So let's go ahead and refresh this. Now you can see 0, that's at position, this is at position 0, is at position 5, and is at position 8, example is at position 11, and string is at position 19 inside of our string here. So they're the three different arguments you can give in this, or the three different values rather you can give in this argument. There is a last, let's just change this back to, yeah, we'll change it to, we'll leave that at 1. The third argument that we can give is a list of words that we want to include as words. So by default, a full stop will not be included as a word. So because this is part of string here, what we could do is come in here and specify a full stop, for example, inside our single quotation marks. So we're specifying the full stop is part of a word. So now what's going to happen is, let's say we we'll return one and we refresh. You can see that we're still giving back an associative array, even though, well, let's put that at zero, for example. And we'll just echo out this. What you can see that's happened is we've still got five words, but if we then go back and if we then go back and change this value up here to one or two, so we're producing either our array or our associative array, you can see that instead of just string, we've got string with the full stop on the end there. So now let's go ahead and separate this full stop from the word string and refresh, and you can see it's given us five different, or six different words.